is what you missed.
Asibeke nje sithombini mnganami ukuthi uqale kuphi uzube la usukhona.
Dadi wami, it was moving into dance, not far from FUBA, before the last days of FUBA. I studied dance there and not for so long.
Yeah.
I moved to the Market Theatre Laboratory.
Sure.
That's where I studied drama, graduated 2005, did an exchange program, went to Sweden, came back and started doing some ECD programs and workshops, teaching people how to teach kids. And quickly realized that the stage is missing me. Then I did my first musical celebrating the life of Jared Sokoto, who was a famous South African fine artist and painter who died in France. And so we're just making his life on stage at the Market Theater. And since then, I've never looked back. I realized that entertainment is my thing. I was very much at home on stage. I got introduced to television. It hit me like being deep and fit, you know, one of my camera out three all at the same time. So And so I stopped doing multicam and then continued with children's theater. I got my mojo back and then I went back to television, did my first movie, and I've been doing television and film ever since.
There was ever a time where you had to really hustle your way into the industry. Let's talk about that hustle. Yeah, how it started. Like labegu rafcon.
Yo, it's been rough, I'm afraid. Like, sure. Rough for Mundo Mnyame Africa. That's just the reality. But for me, at drama school, I had a bursary. So the bursary included transport money, accommodation. But me and my other friends...
Uholi stipend.
Yeah, stipend.
Ufund, ufund iswa.
Yeah.
Uhola.
Stay in travel.
Those are
SNT.
Levels.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
So we would leave the house that we were accommodated at some commune house in Observatory. So we would walk from Observatory to Newtown. Just to save that money. And then we would usher in the evening at the theater just to see more work being done by professionals while we were still going through training. And even after that, staying in Bez Valley, we still needed to walk to Noord so that we can catch a taxi to the north instead of catching two taxis, because you understood the hustle.
Yeah.
We'd go to an audition. If one of five of my friends were invited to a casting for an advert, we'd all rock up, five of us, on some Mpinjamanga Tolu is a Tolua Yim. And either way, the 12.5 Mpupis is a Shera Songo, because we don't got food at this moment.
So, Oban, because I'm sure there it's some of
the stand-up comedian.
Okay.
We used to walk from
in the same commune.
I was just above the hill.
Oh.
So I would go down by House Africa, where House Africa used to be on the road. And then we walked to Benmore to where Heat Casting was.
Yeah.
There's also Umenzi Wagabiela, he does ads and other television programs. There's also Makoba, Sandile Makoba. There's also Andile Mkati. He's a great voice over artist. We're always in competition about this voice bookings. It's a lot of us, Joe, like before graduation and even after graduation, trying to kick doors to get into the industry.
Fantastic.
Wow, that's beautiful that you guys even hustled like that together, not just one by one. Lekhwapan, do you still see that kind of hustle in the new and upcoming actors and actresses?
I'm not gonna lie, I'm hardly there to witness it, because when I go to auditions, these young ones, they roll up in cars, maybe even if it's a Yaris, you know. We didn't have Yarises, we didn't even have a driver's license. Like, a driver's license was something you thought you had to buy, because we couldn't afford a lot of things, you know. So ours was just to get our names into the industry, get some money, get a learner's license, get a driver's license, get your Beetle as your first car, and the oil is more expensive than the petrol, and then you realize you don't have to do this, then you park the Beetle, and then you buy a scooter, no learner's license whatsoever, and you're just hustling punctuality. You're saying to everybody that's booking you, I'm on a scooter, I'm probably 15 to 20 minutes away from work. Hit me. No, Number Number was a South African production. It was my first film with Donovan Marsh. He did Spider. We had lots of fun with other characters or other actors like Israel Magwe. And everybody who was a part of the film was asked to go back to the community and bring their own language. So I went back to Soshanguve and brought my language. And I had so much fun on that show, I mean on that film, that it had opened doors for every other film I did. After Number Number, I did Nothing for Mahala. After Nothing for Mahala, I did a philanthropist, a couple of them, but eventually landed to got to work with Agino Motosho on this one called Vaya.
Let's talk about Vaya. Coming out on Friday.
We're gonna shut it down. SA, South Africa, we need to shut it down. So Vaya comes out on Friday the 27th nationwide. If you want to know where it's playing, you can go into my social media and you'll see the theaters that are screening.
Is there
it.
A trailer up already?
There is a trailer.
Please want to Google it for me.
There's a trailer. I've also got it on all my social media timelines.
Fantastic.
It was great to work with Agino Motosho because I've been waiting so long. I asked him about 4 years, well, 5 years ago. I told him, Akin, I would love to work with you. And he said, don't worry, brother, don't worry. It's going to happen. And when it happens, you will know. And so 4 years ago, then he called me in, did an audition here on 40 Keys. You guys are what? 39?
Yeah.
Went to 40 Keys. I did the audition. Flip, it was so good. But then he didn't call me for 3 weeks. And then I thought, I didn't get the role. And I got a call a week before shooting. And he said, what do you mean? I told you I also want to work with you, so come, we can do. And then I went on set, and then we had fun, bro.
Wow. How long was the shoot?
The shoot was about 6 to 8 weeks.
Wow.
But I think I must have shot like 5 weeks.
And locations?
Soweto, one of the dopest locations was City Deep, where they dump all the dead and crap and all the diapers.
Yes.
Yeah, we shot
my container.
Yeah. But right on top of the Golden Hill Corsan, in Boisen's Terfontein. And it smells like it's got a stench. And it was cold. It was like 2 degrees at some point when we were shooting one of the scenes, my character introducing the cousin character to Johannesburg and stuff like that.